Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum. Straight talk about you and your money. Now from the BizTalk studios, here is Gary Kaltbaum.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. I'm Adam Sarhan, in for Gary K, who's out today. Today is Monday, March 4th, 2024, and we've got a great show for you tonight. I want to thank you very much for being here. Before we dive into the show, just a quick housekeeping note. As you know, this is a show about you and your money and all the fun points in between. Just as a quick reminder, if you don't get this show in your city, you can go to GaryK.com, listen live or archive. We are live Monday through Friday, 6 to 7 p.m. Eastern. Also at GaryK.com, you can follow Gary on X, formerly known as Twitter, just by pressing the button. Also at GaryK.com, you can subscribe for free to get Gary's morning notes sent to you directly to your inbox, email Gary about his money management services, or join convictionleaders.com, which is his premium stock market membership website. And there he shares his thoughts on the market several times throughout the day. And he's got nightly, sometimes more, in-depth market webcasts. How about timely market webcasts? He had one earlier today. I believe he's doing another one later tonight. And weekend webcasts where he shows you what he's saying. He gives you updates written. Really, really just a great, great, great service at convictionleaders.com. So let's talk about the market. As you know, Gary does the specifics and he does day-to-day. I'm not on often, so I like to go broad and share more of the timeless lessons that I've learned along the way to help you ultimately make better decisions. But let's talk about a few things. First off, caution is important in my world right now. Why? Because we've had a huge move. And the first few minutes of the show today, I want to speak about the importance of timing. You know, in life, timing is so incredibly important. Think of the, and the same thing in the market. Think of the proverbial guy meets girl, right away, first question out of his mouth, hey, want to get married? Most likely, she's going to say no. Nothing's wrong with that guy, nothing's wrong with that girl. Same guy, same girl, fast forward 6, 12, 18 months, 24 months, 36, I don't know. And then timing is right. Same guy, same girl, same question, could get a completely different answer. Now, it doesn't mean she'll say yes in 18 months or 24 months or whatever it is, but the likelihood, the probability of a yes is great, is much higher. Same thing in the market. Timing is so important. So ask yourself, am I early to the party or am I late to the party? And a lot of times people get FOMO, which is fear of missing out, or, you know, just fear kicks in. And Warren Buffett's got a great line with fear, where he says people should be fearful when they're greedy and greedy when they're fearful, meaning switch it. You know, that's why they say markets are counterintuitive in nature. So timing, fear, greed, you know, all of these things are just really, really important. It brings us back to the market. Where are we right now? Buying up here, nothing's wrong with buying up here if that's what you want to do. Obviously, you know, you do whatever's best for you. But from my standpoint, I want to exercise, and just caution is key. It's paramount, because after every big move up, there's only two ways the market can consolidate that move. One, it goes sideways, or two, it goes down. That's it. Now, after that consolidation, or that base, or that pullback, or that, you know, whatever word you want to use to explain it, most likely in uptrends, the uptrend resumes. You get another leg higher. But there's a consolidation first. And you can, don't take my word for it. Go look at the market. Look at any other cycle throughout history. And you'll see it time and time again, even in very strong periods. The consolidations come in all different shapes and sizes. Some are small, some are long, some are deep, some are narrow, so on and so forth. But they consolidate. So if loading up the truck now, after a big move up, are you early to the party or are you late to the party? And to me, one of the most important things to ask is, where is the market with respect to this? The two most popular ones are the 50-day moving average and the 200-day moving average. Now, if you look at the NASDAQ 100, the QQQ, which is the strongest index out there, you can look at the S&P 500, SPY, or the Dow, the DIA. These are all ETFs that track the indices. You can see that they're way above their 50 and their 200-day moving averages. Now, there's no rule that says you have to go down and touch the 50. or you have to go down and touch the 200. In fact, most of the time during strong uptrends, they don't touch the 200, and they'll occasionally touch the 50 a handful of times in a 12 to 18 or 24 month period in a very, 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 very robustly strong environment. Very strong environments are rare, but they happen. And you can go back and look. But even in prior strong environments, you can look at 2013, you can look at 2019, 2017 was a strong period, lots of other years as well. After COVID, you had a huge rally where the market basically doubled in about 18 months from March of 2020 up until November of 21, where you had a huge move in a very short amount of time. All of these times throughout, and you can go back and look at the late 90s, you study history however you want, you'll see there are times where you get these explosive rallies and the market just feels like it's never going to go down. And then what happens? Inevitably, over time, it goes down and it pulls back and it consolidates. Even in 2021, it pulled back several times and touched the 50, also broke the 50. In March of 21, it was below the 50. So, and then it took off and went. So I hope that's helpful. I just want to be the voice, you know, Gary's the voice of reason here. So I'd like to be the voice that supports the voice of reason. Exercise caution, because think of a red light, green light. After every red light, you get a green light and vice versa. So after a huge move up in the market, you get years where, periods where, okay, we just had a big green light, which is a big rally in the market. It's normal and healthy to see it pull back. It's just the way it works. So doesn't mean we can't keep going up. Of course we can. We can keep going up. Again, about probabilities. Just like that point, you know, the guy meets the girl. Okay, or the man meets the woman. Okay. Could she say yes day one out of the gate? Yeah, possibly. But the probabilities are much higher if he waits for the time to be right. So keep that in mind, folks. Again, I'm not saying sell everything, go to Canada. That's not at all in any way, shape, or form. I want the message to be clear. The environment is extremely bullish right now. And we're seeing the rally broaden out. And that's a healthy sign. And we saw a brief consolidation. The NASDAQ 100 QQQ moved sideways for about 3 weeks and then broke out late last week, which is bullish. The Russell 2000. You can look at the IWM if you're following on a computer, or the MDY, the mid caps. They were largely lagging for a large portion of this rally up until just a few weeks ago. And late last week, the Russell IWM on Friday broke out of its little handle or a nice sideways consolidation. And the mid caps broke out about a week and a half or 2 weeks earlier and followed through. Now they're extended. So that's encouraging to see the rally broaden out. And that's what we're looking for. Just more signs of, okay, this rally is working. That's good. And in the early phases of a new bull market, like we're in now, you see these really strong periods where it's almost like the market defies gravity, if you will. But it doesn't last forever. And then if you get in after that big move up, thinking it's going to continue, or you FOMO in, then all of a sudden it pulls back, or even if it just corrects a little bit, bam, you get tagged. Tagged is another way of saying get stopped out or pressure, whatever it is. That's all. I just want to be very, very clear. People always come to me and say, oh, what do we do? What do we do? What do we do? What do we do? Well, do what's right for you, number one. But number two, just understand timing is really important in this business. All right. That being said, spoke about FOMO, fear, greed, Buffett's line. Markets are counterintuitive in nature. Most people are greedy when they should be fearful and fearful when they should be greedy. As an example, in real life, what does that mean? Somebody buys a stock at 10 bucks. It goes to 11. Immediately, you know, sells it. Because they're fearful, the profits are going to get erased. It's going to rotate back and go down to 9 or 8 or 5 or whatever it is. So he sells his winner early. But if that stock is going to double and go to 20 or triple and 30 or 40 or 50 or 100, it has to go to 11 first. So that's one example. In that example, he's saying, let your winners run. You know, don't be fearful in that case. Be greedy. Let it go. You know, get out of your own way kind of a thing. Now, on the other way, the other example, fearful when you should be greedy and then greedy when you should be fearful, the other side of that coin is you buy it at 10, it goes to 9. people just say, oh, please, God, let it get back to even. Please, let, you know, just get back to even, get back to even, get back to even. Instead of being fearful it's going to go to five, what are they doing? They're being greedy and hoping they can get back out, get a break even. But the stock's not working. It's going against them. That makes sense? So that's what Buffett means by flipping the switch, so to speak, or flipping those emotions. Psychology is super, 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 super important. Muy importante, like they say. I have a book. It's called Psychological Analysis. It was number one on Amazon for every day for 3 months. And the idea there is to help you remove the emotions from the decision-making process. Teach you how to make rational, not emotional decisions. Up next, we've got a lot more to cover. I'm Adam Sarhan. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
Hi, I'm Gary Kaltbaum, host of the nationally syndicated radio show Investor's Edge. We're not just handsome radio people. We manage investors' money for a living, specializing in fee-based discretionary money management. No big commissions, just a fee on the assets that's managed. We also provide a full range of personalized services, including retirement planning, fixed income, and educational needs, all to assist you in achieving your financial goals. Understanding not all individuals have the same needs, we'll carefully evaluate your personal goals to determine a proper investment strategy. If your current approach to investing is not getting you to where you would like to be, call us to make an appointment for a complimentary portfolio review. The number to call is 888-422-5559. That's 888-422-5559. That's 888-422-5559. Investment advisory services offered through Kaltbaum Capital Management.
It's time to switch on the integrator units and get the brain cells working.
You're listening to...
Hey, this promises to be fun.
Investor's Edge.
The last bastion of quality programming.
With Gary Kaltbaum.
It doesn't get better than this.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. In case you're just joining us or missed any part of the show, you can go to GaryK.com. Listen live, archive, rewind, fast forward on any device you want 24/7, all for free. On GaryK.com. All right, so we spent the first part of the show going over the major indices, saying that the environment remains very strong. We are extended in the short term, intermediate, long term. The, you know, the conditions remain very, very strong. I'm of the mindset we're in the early stages, the first year or so of a new bull market. Typically in these early stages, you see very strong animal spirits, is another word that they use on Wall Street. You see a very strong rally to indicate that the market is moving up. You basically defy gravity for a little bit of time, but it doesn't last forever. And that's the important thing that I want to be able to, the message I want to convey to you, because it's really, really important to understand that nothing lasts forever on Wall Street. And the state of the market changes. That's the next thing I want to discuss with you, is that the state changes. So when you're in a situation where the state changes, you have to understand this. There's, what are the states, right? There's three possible states, and I cover this in the book too, where the environment ebbs and flows. One would be an uptrend. You know, after you buy a stock, folks, there's only three things that can happen. It can go up, it can go down, or it can go sideways. I'll say that part again because it's very important. After you buy a stock, or any asset for that matter, a currency, a commodity, even a real estate, a house, whatever it is, the price can only go up, down, or sideways. Okay, great. Well, the idea is to be able to make a plan for if it goes up, what are you going to do? If it goes down, what are you going to do? If it goes sideways, what are you going to do? Right? This way, you're not caught off guard if and when it goes sideways and or it goes down after you buy it. So how high does it go up? Nobody knows. And we don't, quote unquote, have to know. But what we can do is say, oh, hold on a second here. We can be prepared for it. If it does go up by X amount, I'll be ready to do A, B, C, or D. So, and then more importantly, if it goes down on us, we know before we enter how much we're going to risk if we're wrong, where we're going to exit if we're wrong, and what happens to our portfolio if we're wrong. That's super important. So the states, up, down, sideways, right? In an uptrend, uptrends come in different lengths, shapes, and sizes. Some are last a few years, some last a few weeks, some last a few months. But even in those uptrends, you get pullbacks, you get consolidations, the state changes, right? Sometimes you're going down on a daily chart, but you're going up on a weekly or monthly chart, or even an intraday chart or something, you know. So the state changes. Understand where you are is really, really important. Big picture, the bigger, for me, I'm a big picture guy. The more I zoom out, the better my decisions are, the better my returns are, the more aligned I am with the broader trend. And then I understand the state, I can reverse back, you know, reverse engineer it, so to speak. Say, oh, okay, are we in an uptrend? Yes, on a monthly chart, for example. Great. How about a weekly? How about a daily? And then where am I buying? Am I buying early? Am I buying late? So on and so forth. And there are certain times where you would expect something to happen, but it doesn't. And or vice versa, you know. Just understand the state's change. That's an important thing. For stocks, for ETFs, for markets, you know, the major indices, so on and so forth. And then where you are, the timing part is really, really important. All right, spoke about all that. Now let's talk about some strength. On Monday, we've got SMCI, Super Micro Computer, gapping up today about 20, well, I'm going to use a percentage, double digits to a new all-time high. This stock had a huge run from the mid-300s earlier this year, all the way up until, let's see, it was January 19th it broke out, all the way up to about 1077 on the 16th of February. And then it pulled back from 1077 all the way down to about the high 600, 692, about 4 days later. Doesn't even touch the 21-day moving average. Talk about how strong it is. Rallies back up, pulls back again. So rallies back the next day on the 22nd, all the way up to over 1,000. Then 2, 3, 4, 5 days later, you're back down to 800. You just lost 20%. And then the last 3 days, it goes from 812 to the high, well, to over 1155. That's a huge, huge, huge move, or to 1155. That's a huge move. It's a big swing, and it shows you how volatile markets can be, and individual stocks. Now, SMCI is up so much today because there's news that it's being added to the S&P 500, and that's now going to attract a lot more buyers. Now, granted, the stock just went from 357-ish to over 1,000 in a few weeks, 5, 6 weeks here. You know, January, the stock was at 275. It closed last year at, where were we? At about 285, thereabouts. That's a huge move in a short amount of time. Now, does it mean it's going higher? It could. It could rally today and then fall the next few days. Typically, you have those climax runs where the stock goes from 350, more or less, to 1077 in a few weeks. And most of that move happened the last, you know, week or two of that, where it was up like 40% or 50% in a week. And then it goes from 1077 down to 800, or sorry, 692 in 2 days' time. That typically is a climax top. But then you get a major news event where it's added to the S&P 500. All right, things change. But even now, with the 50-day moving average, it's still all the way down at 556, and the stock's over 1,100. So timing, again, matters. Now, somebody wants to be aggressive and buy it, they can do whatever they want. I wouldn't touch it up here. I'd rather wait for a consolidation. And if I miss it, so be it. That's the other thing, is I'm not going to catch all the big monster stocks, and that's okay. That's really, really important, too, is I'm not going to catch them all, and that's okay. I've learned that the hard way. I used to beat myself up. Ah, coulda, woulda, shoulda. How could I not get that? How could I miss that? I saw that. It's just mental torment for no reason. I'm not going to put that trade on. You know, I think in decisions or trades, in my mind's eye, there's an element of risk. There's an element of reward. Every decision I make, cross the street, go here, go there, lunch, dinner, blah, blah, blah. Doesn't matter. Big decision, small decision. Element of risk, element of reward. Can I quantify that? How do I quantify it? So on and so forth. So that's a big mover today, SMCI. Okay. That's on news. Next thing, these crypto Bitcoin stocks, MicroStrategy, MSTR, on fire this year, really, the last few weeks since mid-January. Well, really since not mid-January, early February. It just took off and went, and volume has exploded on the up days. This thing super extended also. Bitcoin, just be careful, folks. I mean, do what you want, but IBIT, IBIT, is one of those new ETFs that tracks Bitcoin. It came public, started trading on the 11th of January. High was $30. A few days later, IBIT's down to 22. Then it consolidates a little bit, breaks out of the little consolidation on the 7th of February at $25. Now you're at 38. Could it keep going up? Sure. In the near term, is it extended? Yes. So always ask yourself, where are you in the move? Are you early? Are you late? And if you miss it, so be it. There's always another opportunity, just like another elevator, another bus. Anyway, up next, we've got a lot more to talk about. I'm Adam Sarhan. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
You're listening to
America is Talking
Investor's Edge.
He's got to be pleased with that. The crowd is just on his feet here. Cinderella boy.
With Gary Kaltbaum.
Comes highly recommended. You're going to feel better if you talk to him.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. I'm Adam Sarhan, in for Gary K, who's out today. In case you're just joining us or missed any part of the show, you can go to GaryK.com, listen live or archive, live or archive 24/7 on any device you want, anytime you want, for free, all on GaryK.com. So, and I know lots of you like to do that when I speak, because I tend to go fast. I have a lot I want to cover in just a short amount of time. So you can pause it, rewind it, fast forward, or follow at home if I talk about any kind of specific stocks or go through numbers or anything along those lines, or ETFs. It's, feel free to do that. So we spoke about Bitcoin or crypto and crypto-related stocks. They're extended. It's okay. That doesn't mean they're not going to keep going higher. They can. But near term, from risk-reward standpoint, the probability, is this a good entry? My thought process, and I could be wrong, of course, I'm a human, I make mistakes all the time, is I'm going to let it pass. It's not for me. I have no interest in chasing something that is so high. Like Gary says, it's in the trees. This is this is tippy top of the trees, if not higher. I just pass. And that's okay. Will I catch every single one? No, it's like the high school boy and the girl. Think of it this way. The boy wants to go in there and kiss all the pretty girls. You can't do that. It's just not possible. You don't have to. You get one, you're very happy. Same thing with the stocks. You get one or two good monster stocks and they hold it right and trade it right for the course of a year. It'll make your year. Two or three and you're loving life. So I've learned to not beat myself up with these things. Let them go. And if I catch them, I catch them. God bless. But let them go. And then I'm always looking for new breakouts. I want to find the setups before they break out and then be ready when they do break out. That's what I do. I share my thoughts on findleadingstocks.com. If anybody wants, they can take a free trial. It's findleadingstocks.com. And bam, here's a list that I shared earlier today. It's SMCI. You got MicroStrategy, BGC, another stock that broke out today. BGC. These are not buy recommendations. These are not anything to do with specific entry points, exit points, none of that stuff. It's just real simple. Here's what's catching my attention. BGC, Finance Investment Bankers, great. Stocks up big, broke out, pulled into the 50-day moving average, volume decline, explodes today on heavy volume right off the 50. KB, another, and I'm going to get there in a second, another thing that caught my attention today are these banks. Right? Money's rotating into banks. KB. This is a foreign stock, South Korean stock, but cup, handle, getting ready to break out today, if not slightly broke out. All right. Another bank. Well, I'll get... let's sort this by price. I'll come back to... We got some more banks on the list, but let me keep going through the list here. COHR, another one, Coherent. electronic parts. Stock had a nice little gap up. When was it? Actually, not even little. Wrong word here. Big gap up on the 6th of February. Stock was up, I don't know, what's 17% in a day on monstrous volume. Average volume here is about 2.3 million shares. That day, it had about 12 million shares, 11.6 million shares. Those are the big institutions. COHR is the ticker. Then it pulls back into the 21-day moving average. Volume dries up and then comes up the right side Friday and then again today, breaks out today, and bam. That is very, very good action. Short term, it's extended. The 50-day moving average is down at $50.88. Stock's at 67. But good action. YPF gapped up today. Oil and gas integrated stock. All right. Tried to break out. Pulled back a little bit. Well, let it pass. KFRC, K-Force. Another one that caught my attention today. This is a thinner trader, only 100,000 shares a day. So I'll pass. People ask me all the time, what's your process? And that's what I'm doing here. I'm sharing you my process. I always like to say the market's speaking and then ask, are you listening? Our job is to listen to the market. Well, it's not going to speak English to us. Traditionally, I'm speaking to you. You can hear me speaking word for word. Okay. The market, like lots of things in life, it speaks but in subtleties. It leaves clues. Success leaves clues. It's a great line from Tony Robbins, Jim Rohn, all these guys. Success leaves clues. Well, the market's speaking. I ask, I wrote this in the book. Are you listening? And this is how I listen to the market. Okay? I look for themes. Another stock, BBAR, Banco BBVA Argentina, Argentinian bank, breaking out today. And we had another bank broke out today. Oh, there's a theme there, right? Let's see, LYB, another one that came up on the list. Chemicals stock, Netherlands company, broke out today. All right. Western Union, WU, broke out today. Again, these are not buy recommendations. Just I'm giving the example of what I do all day is I want to look at the market and listen to it. What's moving? Where's the money flowing? What's breaking out? What's setting up? Because anyone can tell you after the stock breaks out. That's the easy part for the most part. It's being ready to watch these things over the weekend or at night or during the day. Have your ready list, your action list, your focus list, your universe list, whatever you want to call it, top stocks list. Have a broad list and narrow it down. That's what I do. I share my list on the weekend report every week. Western Union, WU, broke out today. All right. Bank of America, BAC, broke out today. Let's see, what else do I want to share? Jefferies broke out today, JEF, Jefferies Financial Group, right? Let's see, we've got so many of these things today. BlackRock, BLK, Credit Corp, BAP. BAP pulled back a little bit in the afternoon. Look at BlackRock when you have a chance. And Gary gave this out on convictionleaders.com earlier today. BLK. They've already reported earnings, these banks. They usually report at the beginning of earnings season. So that's out of the way. Stock consolidated the last few months. Volume, for the most part, dried up as it was consolidating, which is bullish. And breaks out today on above average volume. This is BlackRock, BLK. That's bullish. So out of my list of, I've had over 20 stocks, I didn't share them all here, but I published on FineLeaning Stocks today, about 23 stocks, I think it was, or over 20 stocks that jumped out at me around noon Eastern, like I do every day, just the breakouts or just some thoughts I have. I give a pre-market report, a weekend report, midday breakouts report kind of a thing, or a video, depending on, again, market action, not every day. But when I see something like this, the market's speaking, hey, money's rotating into these financials. So I'm going to go look at the XLF and say, hey, is there something to do here? Take a look. Well, it's a little bit extended here. Well, it's decently extended. All right, broke out back in January, had a nice run. Now it's just sitting tight. It's forming a 3 weeks tight pattern or two. It had a 2 weeks tight. This is the third week. It's probably going to break out and go. All right, let's look at some of the other financials. This is what I do for fun, but fun is in quotes here. This is my hunting and gathering. This is my work. Like the cavemen used to go hunt and gather, you know, saber-toothed tigers or fight or whatever it was. This is my version of hunting and gathering, because all this translates into, you know, life-changing success on the other side of this, or real, it's massive impact. So JP Morgan, JPM, it's extended, hit a new high today. Goldman Sachs is setting up nicely, hasn't broken out yet. Again, these are not buy recommendations. No investment advice is being given here. But Goldman Sachs is setting up nice, just above the 50, right? Morgan Stanley, MS, big gap up today above the 50-day moving average, and triggered one of my early entry points. I have an amped investment system, which I outline in the book. A is advanced entry points or early entry points. This is it. You've got a downtrend line that's broken. Stock gaps up, gaps above the 50, and does it on very heavy volume. Well, like Gary says, it's not Aunt Mary and Uncle Bob doing the buying. It's the big institutions. So there's that. All right? You get the hint? I mean, I'm passionate about this stuff, but this is what drives me. BX, Blackstone, hasn't broken out yet, but you've got a nice pivot point at 131.29. All right? I'll be watching it. That was added to the S&P 500 recently too, along with Airbnb, ABNB. Airbnb's extended, nothing really to do right now. But Blackstone, I'll be watching that for a breakout above 131.29. KKR, riding the 21-day really nicely. Extended up here, but really nice action and strong volume coming into this stock. And it's had a huge move since November. Really strong move. I think we've only had 1, 2, 3 down weeks since November in KKR. That's strong. So, always be humble and listen to the market. Up next, we've got a lot more to cover. I'm Adam Sarhan. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
You're listening to...
What are we waiting for?
Well, what are you waiting for?
One, two, ready, go.
Action! Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. I'm Adam Sarhan, in for Gary K, who's out today. Today's Monday, the 4th of March. We've covered a lot of ground, gone through my process, some of it, and I've got a much longer process, but I share with you some of what I do every day, some of my high-level thinking, zooming out, always asking myself, am I early, am I late? And when I'm late, I let it pass. It's not for me, and that's okay. It's all about probabilities. The other thing is mindset that I want to spend a few minutes talking to you about. You know, you look at a cup, is it half full or half empty? Well, technically, they're both correct. How do you want to live your life? In scarcity, thinking it's half empty, I can't take any sip of water because I'm going to run out of water. And constantly in that fear of scarcity and not being aligned, or not have enough and so on and so forth, or just the bad things are going to happen to me and some fear-based thinking and so on and so forth. Or switch it to, not only is there, it's half full, that's even the wrong question to ask, half full, half empty. The right question is, don't even ask the question. There's an infinite amount of water behind it. I'll drink this half cup of water and I'll go fill it up 100,000 more times, a million, a billion more times. And just take that element of fear out of the mindset altogether. The market's a state of abundance. Think of frequency. Like, you know, when you have an AM dial or FM dial. Let's say you got music on 100.7. If you remember, any listeners remember AM or FM. You got 100.7. So you get the dial, you turn it to 100.7, bam, you got music. 100.6, you got static and music. 100.5, you got static. Life, frequencies, we're all different. I'm not going to go off on a tangent here, but the market's a frequency of abundance. That's the message. And a lot of people are in a state of scarcity or not abundance, let's put it that way, fear-based thinking. I was for years. I can speak it from experience. But one of the things that transformed my life and my results in the market was that conscious shift to a state of abundance and happiness and alignment and bliss. Happiness is a choice. You can choose to be happy, or you can just let, you know, things happen and so be it. You could choose to look at the cup being half full, or choose to look at it being half empty, or choose to just erase that question and focus your attention somewhere else. You know, where you, wherever you focus is where the attention, you know, your attention is, and that's where your energy flows. So it's your choice. And that is extremely empowering. I can't control what happens to me in life. Nobody can. You know, God forbid something happens, as an earthquake, a tornado, a car accident, a diagnosis, a bad diagnosis, whatever. Doesn't matter what happens to you in life. These are events. What matters is how you react to them. And that you can, I can control. I don't know you, so I can't speak on your behalf, but people can control it. I'll speak generally. Like I do, everything I say is general in nature. People can control how they react to it. You got to teach yourself how to control it. But just because something quote unquote bad happens to me doesn't mean I have to get angry, frustrated, or enter any other negative emotion. I got stopped out of a stock. I used to get upset. I used to get frustrated. Now, it's another one of those. Like Ray Dalio talks about, which he's got a great book. It's called Principles. I recommend people read it. I'm not affiliated with him. It's just a good book, and I like sharing knowledge. And in it, he talks about studying history. You see certain patterns, certain things happen over and over and over and over and over again. One of those things, well, over time, you just start seeing these things happen again and again and again. And you're like, oh, okay, it's another one of those. It's not the first time the sun comes up, not the first time it rains, not the first time there's an earthquake. Could be rare there's a hurricane or an earthquake or a tsunami or whatever the event is. And if somebody's young and they've never experienced it, or even older, they've never experienced it, hey, maybe they think this never happened before. Most likely it has. It's another one of those. COVID, pandemic, global world shuts down because of the flu. I wasn't around 100 years ago when there was a global pandemic. I don't think anybody listening to the shows was around back in 1919 and remembers it. How about that? Okay, but it happened before, and it's likely going to happen again. There was a plague, and you know, so on and so forth. These things happen, disease, outbreak. But if somebody doesn't understand history, they're like, oh, it's never happened before. The whole world's not going to shut down. People aren't going to wear masks. Well, it happened. So it's another one of those. You can't control what happens to you in life, but you can control how you react to it. And again, some of these things set me free. Small, subtle shifts in mindset have the power to change people's lives. And that's what gets me going the most. If you really want to know, people ask, why you do this, that, and the other thing. And thank you for sharing. You're generous with your time. I love the impact and hearing the way, you know, changing lives for the better is absolutely one of, if not the most rewarding things I do. It's not the money. The money is a byproduct. It's the impact. It's the results. It's having somebody that I mentored or somebody that I shared a nugget of wisdom with that I don't know email me and say, hey, Adam, you changed my life. You helped this. You set me free. You did that. You did that. You know, that kind of stuff. It doesn't happen 10,000 times a day, but whenever it does, I take it with a big, you know, please and thank you and a cherry on top. Some of the reviews on Amazon, you can go to Amazon and type in psychological analysis or Sarhan, S-A-R-H-A-N, or Adam Sarhan, you know, whatever you want on Amazon.com, and just read the reviews in the book. Some of them are just fantastic. Somebody just said the other day, it's not even a book about trading, it's a book about life in the review, which I thought was absolutely fantastic. So again, I'm sharing everything with you. We only have, we're about to wrap up. The market is very strong. It's extended in the short term. Could it go higher? Yes. But just, I want to emphasize, green light, red light. Most likely it'll pull back at some point in the near future. We don't know when, but I want to make sure people are prepared for it so they don't get caught off guard. That's the big message. Red light, green light, right? Could it keep going up? Yes. What's the probability? And respect risk. You know, my AMP investment system, D is defense first. respect risk, and you'll be way ahead of the game because most people don't. And then have that abundant mindset. Humble, humility is huge. But have that abundant mindset and get that frequency of alignment with the market where that's abundance. So we're out of time. Thank you all for being here. I believe Gary will be back tomorrow. As always, do what Gary does and hug the children. Have a great day, everybody.
This has been Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum on BizTalk. To listen to past episodes or to get in contact with Gary, go to GaryK.com. That's GaryK.com.